I'm the librarian of the college, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Hidden Science Superstars Unveiling event. I want to wish to acknowledge our distinguished guests, speakers, students, faculty, and staff. If you were here in April for the reveal of the first four honorees, you saw the amazing video testimonials on why they were nominated and heard inspiring words from our provost, Dr. Carolyn Newton.
A moment for the college. In a way, you might think these are objects of limited size relative to the large building that we're putting them in, but this is a big move, and I think it's one that we are in a particularly good position to make. So I want to say a couple of things about that. I'm really delighted that the college has undertaken this project. I think it's a remarkable one. I have the opportunity to talk to folks around the country about Wooster, and I talk about this project pretty often, and people say, wow, that's a fantastic idea. Everyone should do that. And I think, you know, yes, everyone should do that. But I think there's a reason that it's so wonderful that we're doing it here first, and I want to talk about that. What we're doing here really is broadening our iconography, right? Thinking about what is the wide range of inspiring stories of discovery that can dwell among us here at the College of Wooster. And as Irene said, Wooster is premised on a particular founding idea. And that founding idea is that everyone should be welcome in the community of learners on equal terms. Our founding president, in his inaugural address, laid out that importance of being a place of studies for all people, adding that the essential test of citizenship in the Commonwealth of Science and Letters should be character, mental and moral quality, and attainment, not condition or race or color or sex.
Dr. Martha Chase was born in Cleveland, Ohio, and graduated from the College of Wooster as part of the class of 1950. The Hershey-Chase experiment, conducted with her colleague Dr. Alfred Hershey at Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory, helped confirm that DNA is the molecule of inheritance. Her career would later take her to Oak Ridge National Laboratory in Tennessee, the University of Rochester, and the University of Southern California. Alfred Hershey shared the 1969 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine, but Dr. Chase was not recognized at that time.
She went on to complete graduate work at Harvard University and then hold professorships at Stanford and Princeton, the other Wooster. In 2014, Mirzakhani received a Fields Medal, the most prestigious honor in mathematics, becoming both the first woman and the first Iranian to do so. My fellow math majors and I idolize her and were very sad when she passed away last year. And so I'm extremely grateful that we're doing this in her honor. And I'm deeply honored myself to be doing this portrait of her today.
3, 2, 1. You're a mathematician, John.
Was a Persian philosopher and polymath of the Islamic Golden Age who made contributions to physics, chemistry, mathematics, astronomy, and medicine. His encyclopedic works, the Book of Healing and the Canon of Medicine, were used by scholars across the world for a century.
After a short time in the Peace Corps, she was selected for NASA's astronaut program and became the first African-American woman in space aboard the Space Shuttle Endeavour in 1992. Since then, she has pursued a distinguished career of scientific advocacy. She is the current leader of 100 Year Starship, a global initiative with the goal of human travel to another star within the next 100 years.
Federal LSD. STA grants, and we think this might make a wonderful grant proposal. So we were very happy when she followed up with a proposal and we were able to help support this wonderful program. It's now very rewarding to be back a year later to see the result of this tremendous effort that really involved the entire campus. I think that's one of the most inspiring things to me, that everyone across campus had the opportunity to become involved. And so on behalf of the State Library staff, administration, and board, it's my honor to offer our sincere congratulations to all of you as you officially unveil the new portraits and busts of hidden science superstars.
Thank you.